Hi everyone, I'm Emily, and today we are learning the science behind the center of mass. The center of mass of an object is the average position of all the mass in an object. For simple objects like this matchbox here, it's pretty easy to know where the center of mass is. It's going to be right directly in the center of this box. You wouldn't be able to see it by looking at it, but it's right in the center of this matchbox. And it's important to understand where the center of mass is when you're trying to calculate things like where is this object going to go when we push it. So if we push something along the center of mass, it is going to move in a straight line. But if we push something off its center of mass, what's going to happen? It's going to rotate, and it's going to rotate around its center of mass. Now, the center of mass is also important when you're thinking about how to balance an object. One way to balance an object is to put your balancing point directly under its center of mass. Let's think of a truck as an example. Let's say my hand is a truck here, and my watch is the back wheel of the truck, and my ring is the front wheel of the truck. Now, if this truck were evenly loaded, then the center of mass would be somewhere along here. But if we kept adding stuff to the back of the truck, then the center of mass would slowly shift this way, and if we kept loading it, then eventually its center of mass would go beyond its last balancing point, this wheel, and the truck would tip over. And we don't want that, right? So it's really important to understand where the center of mass is and how it changes so that we can avoid things like that. Now, things get really interesting when you have irregularly shaped objects, because sometimes the center of mass can actually be outside the object. To show you what I mean, we have a science demo here. For this science demo, you need a glass, a spoon, a fork, and a couple of matches. So the first thing you want to do is take your fork and bend the middle two prongs out a little bit, and then take your spoon and just insert it into your fork, just like so. Then take a match and put your match in between the middle prongs of the fork, just like that. And then take your glass and balance your irregularly shaped object on your glass. Ta-da! The whole reason this works is because the center of mass of this fork spoon system is actually outside the object. It's not in the fork or the spoon. It's exactly where that match is balancing on our glass. Now take another match and light both ends of the match that's balancing your fork and spoon. It still stays up. That's because the ends of the match weren't doing anything in terms of balance. That balancing point remains intact. It's still right on the edge of the glass. And that is the science behind the center of mass.